Lidly Nation, on today's episode, let's talk about the truth. The truth about bread. Can you handle the truth? Let's find out. Welcome to Live Lean TV. I'm your host, Brad Guthrie from liveleantv.com. So let's talk about bread. So raise your hand right now if you hate bread. Guys, I love bread, but I love my body more. So use this video as a reality check. Unfortunately, the wholesome bread that your grandmother made is not the same quality as the bread that you'll find in traditional grocery stores. Oh, how the times have changed. So first of all, just look at the ingredients list. How many different versions of sugar do you actually see? But don't just look for the word sugar. Also be on the lookout for hidden sugar terms like high fructose corn syrup, honey, and molasses, and many other terms as well. But that's not it. Why does your bread need to have 69 ingredients in it? Did grandma use 69? So be on the lookout for any words that you can't pronounce. These are typically additives and chemicals that potentially increase your risk of cancer. So remember when Subway announced that they were removing this chemical right here from their bread? It was like they were doing you a favor. Maybe you just shouldn't have put it in there in the first place. So other additives are actually added to the bread to make it look like bread. Yes, the hybrid grains used in the bread contain less of the nutrients that actually give bread its color. So some food processors actually add caramel coloring to make it look like traditional bread. So speaking of hybrid grains, let's take a look at the wheat that is being used in conventional bread. Wheat is becoming more and more void of nutrients based on the modifications used in the farming practices. So sure, the modifications may increase the crop yield and help resist pests, but in doing so, it's reducing the parts of the bread that contain some nutrients and actually increases the gluten in the bread. So in other words, the hybrid wheat contains less nutrients than the wheat your grandma used to use. So what about the fiber? Well, the industrial processing grinds up the grains into fine particles so it's easier to work with, but this grinding can also negatively affect the fiber. And as you know, guys, the fiber is what slows the absorption of the carbohydrates from the bread, which then helps balance the blood sugar and insulin. So without the fiber, some breads can be digested as quickly as table sugar, which quickly spikes your blood sugar and insulin and increases your hunger so much that you'll likely grab another slice of bread. It's that never-ending cycle of cravings, people. In fact, some conventional breads are actually higher on the glycemic index than table sugar. Now, I'm not saying that you can never enjoy bread. I just want you to be aware of what you're actually eating. If you need bread, I recommend you flex your discipline muscles and save your favorite bread for your well-earned cheat meal. But if you're already lean and you're working out regularly, if you need to, you should stick to sprouted grain bread like Ezekiel or 100% stone ground or stone milled whole grain sourdough bread. Or you can just make your own bread. So it's time to take control back of the ingredients that you're fueling your body with. And by the way, guys, before you go, if you haven't yet followed me on Instagram at Brad Guthrie, now is the time. We just launched hashtag 60 minute swag. So anytime I post something using that hashtag over on Instagram, you have 60 minutes to like and comment on the photo using the hashtag 60 minute swag. I'll then randomly select one person who can win, like one-on-one workouts with us, FaceTime coaching calls, free memberships, free supplements, free training programs, and our cookbooks, and so much more. So make sure you go over there, turn on your post notifications, guys, because it's going down on the gram. I'll see you over there. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and keep living lean.